Hello guys, welcome to ETHIO. This is Solomon. Today I will show you how to make a car follow a curve in Blender. Stay tuned until then. And don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. If you haven't seen our previous tutorial on rigging and animating, I recommend watching it. You can find the link in the description or at the end of this video. Now let's dive into the tutorial. We will start with a simple scene to add some life to the environment. Press 7 for the top view. Then press Shift S and select cursor to center to ensure the cursor is centered. Next, press Shift A, go to curve and select path. Enter edit mode by pressing tab. If the direction is wrong, press S to scale along the x-axis and type -1 to invert it. Again, press 7 to switch to top view. Select the last vertex and press E to extrude in any direction. You can repeat this by pressing E to create your custom path for the car. Now that we have our desired car path, switch back to object mode. To add a road texture, press Shift A, go to mesh and select image as planes. I will leave a link to the road texture in the description for you to download. Once imported, hide the car body for clarity by pressing H. Go to edit mode. Rotate the texture 90 degrees on the y-axis with R and scale it with S until it's close to building or house. Select the building, enter edit mode and move it closer to the road. Duplicate the building with Shift D. Then press Escape to release it. Scale it along the y-axis and invert the direction by pressing -1. Then shift it in the opposite direction. Let's check the render view to see how the texture looks. It appears well placed. Now to proceed, go to the modifier tab and add an array modifier. Increase the count as desired. Adjust the Z value to 1 and X to 0 to correct the direction. Next, add a curve modifier and select the curve under the curve modifier properties. The plane follows, but the road becomes flat and edgy. To fix this, go back to edit mode and by pressing W, subdivide the plane around 10 times. Switch back to object and the road became much smoother. Select the building, go to the modifier tab and add an array modifier to enhance realism. Increase the count as needed. Then add a curve modifier. Then go to objects and select the curve. Drag it with G if you want to reposition it. Press 0 to enter camera view. And unhide the car body with Alt H. Switch to render view. This is a basic building form to create a satisfying scene. Now switch back to solid mode. So now we have to make the car follow the curve. First, hide the buildings with edge for better visibility. To check if the wheels are spinning, select the rim and enter edit mode to delete the selected faces by pressing X. And also select the rim and enter edit mode to delete the selected face by pressing X. To clearly observe the rotation, I highly recommend watching the previous tutorial for rigging I wouldn't cover that here. Select the empty cube. Go to Object Constraint and choose Follow Path. Set the target to the curve. Check follow curve. But if the direction is incorrect, adjust forward axis. For me, minus X direction works. Press animate path and play the animation. Now the car started following the path. The wheel may rotate slowly, but the car moves quickly. So to fix this, select the curve and go to curve properties. The animation frame is set to 100, which makes the car move quickly. Let's change it to 300, slowing the car down. Press 7 for the top view. We can clearly see the direction of the car. Now let's go to the wheel. To determine if the wheel is spinning, first of all, the rotation of the wheel should be fast. So select the wheel and switch to the graph editor. As mentioned earlier, we covered this in the previous tutorial video. Select driver, then the expression value is 3 times var from the previous video. So change the expression value to 5 times var to speed up the rotation. And change the expression value 5 times var for the other 3 wheels similarly. Switch back to the timeline. And remember to review the previous tutorial for a better understanding. Now you can check if the wheel is spinning properly. Hide the road by pressing the H key to view the spinning wheel. Play the animation to observe the wheel's motion. Now the wheel is spinning. Additional tip for you, to have the camera follow the car along the curve. First, select the camera, then hold shift to select the empty cube. Press Ctrl P to parent it to the object cube transform. Now the camera is linked to the car, so it will follow its movement. Press 0 to enter camera view. Finally, unhide the road and the building. Feel free to create your own simple car race or fun scene. This is the final render animation. I hope this tutorial is helpful. So if you like the video, please hit the like button. And if you are new, please subscribe to this channel and join our family. Until we meet again, bye bye.